Good morning, everyone. My today's topic of discussion is the bronchiolar film analysis in the pulmonary diseases. Introduction is, cytological examination of the respiratory specimen is primary and frequently initial diagnostic tool for complicated respiratory symptoms and pulmonary abnormality. Respiratory samples along with the clinical detail, radiological finding and bronchoscopic finding yield better diagnosis. Bronchial brushing and lavage procedure yield better diagnosis than simple exfoliative sample. Various respiratory samples are sputum, bronchial brushing and washing, bulk fluid, guided FNSA, pleural fluid, bronchial biopsies and guided biopsy. The comparison between different sampling techniques and their advantages and disadvantages. Sputum is early morning sputum sample is collected. Advantages is that it is easy to collect. Wider area of respiratory tract is covered. Simple, non-invasive. Good sensitivity for central tumor. Best for screening of the malignancy. Disadvantage, exact localization of the tumor is not possible. Degeneration of the cells occur, not good for peripheral tumor. While bronchial wash, in case of bronchial wash, you use balanced salt solution of normal saline introduced to the bronchoscope and fluid is re-aspirated. Advantage is that cellularity is more than the sputum. Morphology is better preserved. While disadvantage is that better for central lesion is not well visualized. Bronchial brush there is applied on the lesion through the bronchoscope and multiple smears are made. Advantages is that direct visualization of lesion is possible. Morphology is preserved and more sensitive. First, disadvantage is that it is a more sophisticated technique, suitable for only central lesions. While bronchiolar lavage, the advantage is that it is useful to diagnose the peripheral lung lesion like infection, alveolar diseases, high sensitivity in diagnosis, bronchiolar carcinoma. Technical disadvantage is that technical skill is needed. Wide transbronchial needle aspiration is a good for subbronchial lesion and better morphology. But disadvantage is that swelling is needed and sophisticated technique. My topic of discussion is a bronchoalveolar lavage. The BAL is powerful investigation technique in the field of pulmonary medicines. While BAL sample is nothing but the cellular exudate in the peripheral airway and alveolar spaces by instillation and aspiration of normal saline into bronchoscope trap. BAL fluid can also be used for molecular analysis in search of diagnostic and prognostic markers. Indication of the BAL fluids are diagnosis of opportunistic infection like pneumocystis jeroeca, or in case of interstitial lung disease, malignancy, or any case of non-resolving pneumonia. Contraindication, severe coughing like in case of active tuberculosis, dyspnea, cardiac arrhythmia, or recently COVID infection, deranged coagulation profiles. Procedure, it is usually performed under local anesthesia but can also be done under general anesthesia in case of sensitive patient with 5 mm fibrooptic bronchoscope. Bronchoscope is wedged into a subsegmental bronchus at a desired location. 20 ml of normal saline is introduced through the bronchoscope and desired segment of lung and gentle section is done to collect the lavage specimen. This whole procedure is done for 5 times to get a 40 to 50 ml of solution, which is then processed as early as possible. For processing, we use filtration or cytocentrifugation. In our setup, low speed cytocentrifugation is used. Cytocentrifugation, but can sometimes mucus can cause problems, so that you can use nylon gauze for mucus entrapment or sputolysin like DTT. Few slides are air dried for GIMSA and few are wet fixed for PAPSGEN. Bronchiolar lavage specimen. There are criteria for adequacy and inadequacy. Adequacy when there is a more than 2×10^6 cells or more than 10 micropaths per hour power field. Or sometimes your specimen should be considered adequate if it indicates demonstrate specific pathological process like viral infection, neoplasm, fungal or bacterial disease. Inadequacies, paucity of alveolar microphages on preferred glass slide, excessive number of epithelial cells, mucopurulent exudate of polymorphonuclear cell or numerous red blood cells, or sometimes degenerative changes or artificial obscuring the cell identity. On gross examination, in case of pulmonary alveolar proteinosis, on gross examination, we see the opaque, translucent, brownish or sandy colored the fluid. Or alveolar hemorrhage, there is subsequent increase in hemorrhagic fluid. Various staining, PAP stain used to detect cancer and infection, red genes are to detect good at differentiating inflammatory cells, while deep cue modification of genes are oilier or fined for fat embolism, fat and oil lipid aspiration pneumonia, lipid-laden alveolar macrophages, PAS for pulmonary alveolar proteinosis, Jordan stain is used for mycobacteria, while as modified acid-fast stain for nocardia. Silver methanamine used for pneumocystic xerorrhea pneumonia. It is a special stain for pneumocystic xerorrhea pneumonia of some fungi. Normal epithelium lining of respiratory tract. In normal epithelium, there is a lining epithelium associated with ciliated columnar epithelial cell, stem cells, and goblet cells. The ratio of stem ciliated columnar cell to the goblet cell is 4:1, and then a lamina propria. At the various level, respiratory epithelium at the various level of respiratory tract. Upper respiratory tract is mainly lined by ciliated pseudostratified columnar epithelium, or at some point there may be a squamous squamous cell at the point of vocal cord or at the nasal vestibule. Trachea and bronchi, there is a pseudostratified columnar epithelial cell along with goblet cell. While in terminal bronchial, there is a low columnar or cuboidal cell along with club cells called as clara cells. Alveoli is lined by type 1 pneumocytes, which are more than 95%, while type 2 pneumocytes are less than 5%. Type 1 pneumocytes are oval spindle shape, while type 2 pneumocytes are rounded cells. Dust cells and alveolar macrophages. Various constituents we seen on lung sample. Lining cells, which are squamous epithelial cells, ciliated columnar cell, alveolar macrophage, and goblet cell. While associated cell are polymorph lymphocyte or histocytes. Some acellular material like Rushman spiral, ferruginous body, charcot laden crystals, carbon particle, and hemosiderin. And rarely seen contaminant, pollen grains, with material, food particles. In normal finding, we can see alveolar macrophages, neutrophils, polymorphonuclear cells, lymphocytes, and the ciliated columnar cells. About bronchial epithelial cells, these cells are present singly or in a honeycomb-like cluster. They have terminal wall with cilia at one end. Nuclei present basally, round nuclear monomorphic nuclei, inconspicuous nucleoli, and fine nuclear chromatin. Goblet cells, these are present in small cluster. Cell with moderate amount of vacuolated cytoplasm, round monomorphic nuclei. Abundant goblet cells are seen in cases of bronchial asthma or chronic bronchitis. Alveolar macrophages. These are key cell in the diagnosis of sputum sample. Always present singly, round cell with abundant cytoplasm. Cytoplasm filled with sometimes brownish blackish material. Centrally placed kidney shaped nuclei. Bilobe or sometimes multilobulation also seen. Are fine chromatin. There is a various non-cellular component in respiratory sample. These are Crushman spiral, ferruginous body, charcot laden crystal, mucus, and sarcoma bodies. These are the charcot laden crystal, which has bipyramidal needle shaped crystals with pointed ends, and these are Crushman spiral. Crushman spiral and corpse shaped mucus cast, sarcoma bodies. Asbestos bodies, these are the rod shaped, golden brown in color, with two bulbous ends seen in asbestos exposure. There is benign cellular abnormality. Various non-neoplastic lesions may affect different components of the respiratory epithelial cell, such as squamous cell, bronchial epithelial cell, reserve cell hyperplasia, or hyperplasia of type 2 pneumocytes. Abnormality of squamous cell. In abnormality of squamous cell, there may be inflammatory changes which show nuclear atypia, nuclear enlargement, coarse chromatin, and hyperchromasia, or nuclear show degenerative changes. PAP stain, this is a feature of variant of squamous cell, which are small squamous cell with round hypochromatic nuclei. Abnormality of bronchial epithelial cells, term called as ciliocytophoria. In the viral infection, bronchial lining epithelium of the cell may cause there is a detachment of cilia from the cell. It is also degenerative changes. Hypoplastic bronchial epithelia seen in chronic bronchitis, tuberculosis, bronchial asthma. A morphology, there is a papillary cluster of the cells with smooth peripheral outline. Sometimes cilia may be present. Outer cell and in palisade arrangement with monomorphic nuclei. It can be get confused with the adenocarcinoma. bronchial reserve cell hyperplasia seen in infection, injury. The tight cohesive small cluster of the cell with small cells, high NC ratio, scanty cytoplasm, hyperchromatic nuclei, nuclear molding seen. It is get confused with the small cell carcinoma. Hyperplastic type 2 pneumocytes, this is seen in the tuberculosis, pulmonary infarction, radiation injury, chemotherapeutic drug, pneumonia, and in case of intestinal lung disease. Morphology, there is a tight papillary cluster with abundant cytoplasm, enlarged nuclei, fine chromatin with prominent nuclei. How to differentiate between the reactive atypical bronchial cell and malignant cell? Reactive atypical bronchial cell present in the clusters while malignant cell present dissociated cell. While margin of the atypical cell is smooth, while malignant cell have irregular margin. Nuclear crowding not seen in atypical bronchial, while malignant cell have nuclear overlapping. Atypical cell are scanty in atypical bronchial cell, while many in malignant cells. Cilia usually present in atypical bronchial cells, while ciliocytophoria is seen in cases of malignant cells. Nuclear margin is regular in atypical bronchial cell, while irregular in malignant cell. Nuclear chromatin fine atypical bronchial cell, while malignant shows a irregular course in chromatin. Various infection which can be diagnosed on the bowel fluid is a fungal, bacterial, parasite infection and viral. Tuberculosis infection, this is a well-formed epithelioid cell granuloma in case of tuberculosis of lung, and this is a Zdenek positive acid-fast bacilli in case of tuberculosis of lung. The actinomycosis present in the tonsillar tips or gingival surfaces. It is a contaminant of sputum. They appear like cotton ball like floppy on hematoxylin stain with tangled material. Nocardia, it is an aerobic filamentous organism. Inhabitant is soil, commonly seen in immunocompromised patient. It is a slender, filamentous and branching organism, gram-positive with weak acid fast. Aspergillus, it is a septate uniform acute angle branching. Special stain are past mucocarmine or methionine silver. It causes allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis or allergic alveolitis. Occurs severely in immunocompromised patient like having AIDS. Zygomycosis, it includes the various fungi like mucor, absidia, cunningamala, and rhizopus. Special stain are past and mucocarmine. Seen commonly in debilitated patient, diabetic mellitus, renal failure, and immunocompromised patient. And recently, it is most commonly seen in COVID patient. Mucor have broad, non-septed, wide angle hyphae. Cryptococcus. Cryptococcus is caused by Cryptococcus pneumonis. It is a 5 to 10 micron, round with a thick capsule. It is a budding yeast, found in soil, and cause systemic infection, stain with past mucocarmine and alcin blue. Indian ink is a special stain which stain the capsule, show the capsule of the cryptococcus. Candida is now caused by Candida albicans. It is now called as white fungus, small oval budding yeast, elongated pseudohyphae, cause opportunistic infection in immunocompromised individual. Normal commensal of oral cavity and upper respiratory tract. Histoplasma. It is caused by Histoplasma capsulatum. Inhabitant is soil, commonly in immunocompromised debilitated patient. It is a small, round, intracellular histoplasma within the histiocytes. Pneumocystic carinae. It is an opportunistic infection in immunocompromised patient. Best sampling method is a bath. Tissue response to alveolar filled with the eosinophilic material. Sometimes granulomatous inflammation and giant cell reaction is seen. So on cytology, there is a protea appearance, extracellular aggregates, and the not stained by pap. Cup-shaped structure with one surface is flat and other is a central dark zone. Special stain is methionine silver. Cyst of pneumocystic xerovica and Zimsa stain. The internal nuclei of the cyst up to 18 number and cyst is size of 4 to 7 micrometer. This is a pneumocystic carinae on the methionine silver stain. Various substances that get stimulated with the fungus, that these are the RBC, nuclear lobe of polymorphs, talc, and hemocytin. RBC can be differentiated by RBC present in cluster. By nuclear lobe of polymorphs are variable, present in variable size and smaller size, while talc has central hole of the defect. Hemosiderin is variable size particle, absence of internal structure of the formers. There is a malignant finding, epithelial or non-epithelial cancer and small cell or non squamous cell carcinoma. It is mainly present in cigarette smokers who more than 50 year olds may cause bronchial obstruction seen in upper lobe of lung, symptoms like cough and hemoptysis. Earlier stage of radiograph may fail to detect it. In squamous cell carcinoma, we see the whole to polyhedral cell with hyperchromatic nuclei in squamous cell carcinoma of the lung. While in PAPS, we see the polyhedral cell with the orangophilic cytoplasm and dark hyperchromatic nuclei. Next is adenocarcinoma. It is a, recently, it is the most common type of lung cancer seen in women and non-smoker. It is a mostly asymptomatic, and symptoms are chest pain, dyspnea, hemoptysis, easily seen on chest X-ray. Highly metastatic in nature. In case of adenocarcinoma, we see the monolayer of the sheet wall-like clusters of papillary fragment of the cell, round to oval cell with mild to moderate vacuolated cytoplasm, nuclear atypia, fine nuclear chromatin with inconspicuous nuclear, intranuclear inclusion sometimes. DDs are the poorly differentiated squamous cell carcinoma, metastatic adenocarcinoma, reactive bronchial cell hyperplasia, goblet cell hyperplasia, vegetable cells and viral inclusion or hematoma. Small cell carcinoma. It is difficult to identify on the cytology, but small cell lung cancer is the most aggressive form of lung cancer with early mediastinal lymph node involvement. 99% occur in smoker, usually median age group of 60 years. Arise from lobe or major segmental bronchi, associated with the paraneoplastic syndrome. In case of small cell carcinoma, we see the dissociated cells with small dwelling of the lymphocytes, scanty cytoplasm, and hyperchromatic nuclei with inconspicuous nuclei. Differential diagnosis of small cell carcinoma: cluster of lymphocytes seen in follicular bronchitis, carcinoid tumor, lymphoma, metastatic tumor, small cell malignant tumor. Large cell carcinoma, it is a diagnosis of exclusion. It is an undifferentiated malignant epithelial tumor that lacks the cytological feature of squamous, glandular or neuroendocrine differentiation. Histopathological examination is necessary. Large cell carcinoma, we see the large cell with marked nuclear pleomorphism, moderate to abundant cytoplasm, ill-defined cytoplasm with a bizarre nuclei, prominent nuclei and polymorph sticking to the cells. Metastatic malignancy, we need a detailed clinical history for that. Even if aspirated material cytology resembles a previous malignancy at another site, a new primary tumor may be still present, it is difficult to exclude completely, especially in case of adenocarcinoma. Perry et al. Demonstrate that relatively common occurrence of new primary tumor when metastasis were suspected clinically. Metastatic carcinoma may show endobronchial growth, which mimic the primary malignant tumor. IHC marker are the useful in differentiating primary from metastatic tumor. Right. There is a no deficiency report system for BAL, like Bethesda system is present for vaginal cytological report. Like diagnosis of criteria are divided into non-diagnostic specimen, specific benign lesion, or atypical but benign, or atypical suspicious for malignancy or malignant. The summary is that BAL is used for the diagnosis of the various pulmonary disease like infection, especially pneumocystis carinii, or some malignancy like lipidic adenocarcinoma, or it can be used for the diagnosis of alveolar diseases. Or mainly on cytology, we diagnose only the squamous cell carcinoma or adenocarcinoma. It is difficult to diagnose the other malignancy from the cytology. We need for that immunohistochemistry and for molecular study. Okay, thank you.